Can people like step completely out of their body and kind of like, I don't mean like stand beside it, but like they don't go anywhere, or they do go anywhere, and then they pop back in. Like they're not really walking out, like never coming back, like walking out of this reality, but they're like walking out of the body. So like when I look at them, it looks like they walked out. Is this making sense? But then when I look at them again, like the same exact soul frequency, whatever you want to call it, is back in the body.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'll give you an example, like Isabel. So like I think she's been walking out and in, and it's freaking me out because until I saw her do it, because you know I'm with her a lot, talk to her a lot. Like I didn't even know that was possible. Like I always think of in the standard literature, walking out, do you know what I mean? It's like bye, gone. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because to me, then it's more like an OBE. So how would you look at that or explain that? And why, I mean, why would she be doing that? I mean, there must be a reason, because I don't think she's doing it consciously. It's one thing if you're doing, wow, you're out of body, girl. Get in your body.
You're talking about the subject, so I'm like trying to relate. And see how we
sound. Oh my goodness. You know what doesn't fly with me, right? You are hilarious. Okay, sorry, that was so funny. Okay, so before I look at you, what are your thoughts on that before I forget?
I would go with it's more of a consciousness shift, because like you can still be in the body-ish without stepping out of your body or stepping out into the room and getting anywhere. But your consciousness literally shifts. So you are no longer necessarily fully present at the body. Like, let's say 5% is like an anchor that will keep you here. The rest is a consciousness. You can just simply connect to certain knowledge, information, various possibilities and events. Like she, Isabel, can literally look at possibilities, like what does she want to do in life, the job, the specific people she wants to work with and stuff. And she can look at variations and then run a lifetime. But when she does that, her consciousness is not in this physical body as much. She's just tuning into all the possible realities, living it for moments. So when you tune into her and you don't see her in the body fully present, it's when you can have a conversation about cupcakes and she will run all possible realities with all different kind of cupcakes. So she's not going to be fully here, kind of thing.
Is that the nature of her, kind of like you know, you can like shift you're one of the only people I know that can do this, but maybe more people can do it. They just don't know they can do it. And you just know you could do it. Like you can shift your awareness to like, if I'm like go into an alternate reality, like you can totally go first person right now while you're talking to me.
Absolutely.
Right. So is that kind of what she's doing? You're saying, but the difference between her and you is this, you, this perspective knows generally that you're doing it. Maybe not always, but most of the time you would be like consciously doing it. She's unconsciously doing it. Or I'm trying to do that, which I can too, but it takes me a lot more work. I consciously know I'm doing it. Like I'm going there consciously. I'm shifting that consciously. You're saying she's not doing it consciously. At least this her isn't doing it consciously.
More like for a lot of people who are not doing it consciously, and for her too, not too conscious about it, but like everyone can do it because it's like daydreaming. You think of a reality you want to experience and you just jump into it and you play in that reality.
Oh, and it's like when I was reading the Twilight books, when I was working at Kohl's at the customer service, and I was like in it, like I am telling you, and there's a customer pounding on the counter in front of me, pounding, and no consciousness was there. Like I was in Twilight. That's what you're talking about?
Yes.
Kind of?
Yes.
Oh, so she may be kind of doing it in a way, just the words I'm using, she's not conscious of. So you're saying everybody that's like a soul does that to some extent.
To some extent. And but more like daydreaming is like creating a reality. So you think of possibilities where, what kind of cake would you like tonight? And you think of like possibilities where in that reality, you would eat that specific cake and you go with variations. So you are already like creating hundreds of aspects of yourself in different little worlds, in different realities, eating different cakes.
God, I never thought about like such a simple thing. Like if I was picking out wedding cake, you're like, I love pick wedding cake. But I could like run through, like without them putting cakes in front of me, I could run through flavors, and each of those flavors, wedding cake is like a different reality, you're saying.
Yeah.
So we can do it like macro and go world to world, or we can do it micro.